Today I'm analyzing the fight between Beneil Dariush and Tony Ferguson. Coming up. Hi, my name is Mark Leichner and this is Marko, my student. And we're analyzing the fight between Beneil Dariush and Tony Ferguson. And we have a few things that we wanted to discuss. First of all, I want to say that Beneil did such a great job. Tony Ferguson does not look as he used to look before. And I don't see the same confidence, same craziness, if you will, when he fights. But he's still a good fighter, and Beneil did great things. He dominated in the striking. He did some great takedowns, great guard passing. He flattened him out. Ferguson couldn't move, although he did escape a few times, but generally he was outclassed. But Marko has one thing that he noticed during the fight, and I have one. First thing that I want to say is that I didn't like Dariush's ground and pound. He's a great grappler. As Joe Rogan said, he's a BJJ world champion for, or grappling world champion for brown belts. Great, great grappling, great positioning, everything great. So it's not like I'm criticizing him. It's just one segment of the fight that I didn't like, and that's ground and pound. He was wailing during the ground and pound sections in guard. So he was in Ferguson's guard, and instead of him, like, I'll show you what he did first. He was just doing this without any sort of idea, if you will. Tony Ferguson was trying to elbow him down. They were both like doing this just to get the volume of punches in. I don't like that. Why? I think there are much more efficient ways of ground and pounding. And when you do a good ground and pound, passes open up. And vice versa. When you try to pass, ground and pound opens up. So instead, what he should have done from here, maybe body, body, head, maybe elbow, hammer fist, even if he holds my hand, if he can hold my hand and this, maybe then some elevation and then some passes. I mean, I can show you many, many things from here and many principles, but the point is that he should have punched more efficiently. He should have punched with ideas, like to have an idea what he wants, not just well. So other than that, I have no criticism, if you will. This is not a criticism, this is more of a suggestion, so he can make his passing game even better, so he can dominate even more on the ground. But his BJJ roots were clearly visible. Sometimes those BJJers don't incorporate ground and pound that well, which is okay, they have other ways to finish the fight too. But if he incorporates more of a targeted ground and pound, it doesn't always have to be for the head. Jump up, hit, elbow, hammer fist, soften him up, get up, pass the guard. I think it's going to be better. And what did you notice?
So what I noticed was Tony Ferguson's darts. Now, Tony Ferguson is a master of darts, and he ended up in a position where he was in the butterfly guard, I think. And he had not full darts, he wasn't fully locked, it was locked over fingers, which is not something you want to do because it's a lot weaker. But he tried to finish it from here. He tried to squeeze it like a guillotine. Well, you can't do that with darts. What you can do instead is release one of your legs. It doesn't matter which one. Ideally, it's going to be the opposite leg. So if you release one leg and fall on your side, that's when you can finish the darts much more efficiently. You can release the other leg too. Now, this depends on circumstance, of course. If you release the other leg as well, you can fall down here, you can finish darts there as well. Both positions are much better than the position that he was in, because Dariush could squeeze, he could, you know, grind with his shoulder, he could put pressure on, he could break the grip, and all of that stuff that to prevent the darts from being finished, which of course is a bad thing.
Those were the two main things that we noticed during that fight. Just because we didn't cover it, don't think that we haven't noticed the heel hook Dariush put on Tony Ferguson. And just like you, we have no idea how Tony Ferguson's knee didn't blow out. What did you think? Was there any way Tony Ferguson could have won that fight? Like, was there any way that he could have done something to turn the tide of the fight? What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, like it and share it. And you can also subscribe to my channel. And if you'd like a more in-depth MMA training, check out my instructionals. This is Marko Davitkov. My name is Mark Leichner, and I will see you again very soon.